I quite like this little palm plane, and I thought it'd be nice to have another one like that for my other shop. So I figure I'll try making one out of some really hard lignum vitae, trying to make it roughly this size. Now the knife in this one is at about this angle here. And it comes out right about here. So I need to make a cutout in here, roughly like this. So I want to cut this slot on the table saw, something like this, but I need to jig that up somehow. Now I need to get the rest of this out, hopefully without destroying what I've made so far. Now we've got a pin here for clamping down the knife, and since I'm trying to copy this geometry as much as possible, just mark roughly where that goes, right about here. Now I need the hole in exactly the same position on the other side, so I'm just going to jig it up like this to get that hole in there. Now to glue this back together, I'm just going to use some epoxy. And I also wiped it down with a little bit of paint thinner, so hopefully I won't have any oil on the surface, and I hope that will stick well enough. For the pin that goes across here, I just cut off a nail. And that fits through here. And let's just try this out with the parts from the other plane to see if this plane's actually gonna work. I think setting the knife is a little bit tricky on this one because I don't have it sticking out very far in the back. I mostly use this just for roundovers and edges, and it works fine for that. Well, that's not too bad. Now I quite like this handle part on the back for holding it, so I'm gonna add something like that to this one. So this is going to form the handle like this, and this part here is going to be the tenon that fits into this slot here, and the best way to cut this tenon at this point is with my tenon jig. And I just forgot to push record while I bandsawed that out, but I've got a bit more cutting to do to make that a bit round. Now, before I glue this on, I'll just trim the rest of this plane to be a little bit more comfortable to hold. So I ended up tapering it on the back quite a bit because the way I hold this one is usually like this. So if I want to hold this one, I need a bit of space for my fingers to go right here. While I wait for the glue to dry, I need to make one of these parts, and I'll cut that out of this piece of bar stock. I was just puzzling over how to make a thumb screw like this. Maybe just take a regular screw and weld something to it, or maybe just use one with a big head. But then I looked through my screw collection and I found this one, which is just perfect. I got a leftover piece of saw blade that's just barely big enough to cut the blade for my plane out of. First thing I'll do is heat it up to get rid of the coating and soften it. When the steel is hot enough, it loses its ability to attract a magnet, so I'm checking it with a magnetic screwdriver while it's still hot. I heated it up with a blowtorch and then dipped it in used motor oil to quench it and harden it.